So we'll move on to the exercise and few other things related to this story, the portrait of a lady. After understanding the story and the beautiful narration, let's now move to some exercises, some work. To have more in-depth understanding of this very story in terms of content, in terms of feelings, in terms of language, and also in terms of understanding the text. So the first thing that we have to do is few questions. The three phases of author's relationship with his grandmother. When, before he left the country to study abroad, विदेश जाने के पहले जो author है, author इसमें कौन है? Grandson. Author यानी लेखक. इस कहानी को जो describe कर रहा है लेखक, grandson, उसके life के जो तीन phase हैं, जो उसने डिस्क्राइब किया है विदेश यात्रा में जाने के पहले, उसके बारे में बताएं. तो विच आर दोज थ्री फेजेस ऑफ ऑथर्स रिलेशनशिप विथ हिज ग्रैंड मदर बिफोर ही लेफ्ट द कंट्री टू स्टडी अब्रॉड. द आंसर इज, विच आर दोज थ्री फेजेस? फर्स्टली, व्हेन द ग्रैंडसन एज अ स्मॉल चाइल्ड लिव्ड विथ हिज ग्रैंड मदर एंड पेरेंट्स ऑल्सो इन द विलेज where mother would get him ready, give him bath, breakfast, take him to school, and so on and so forth. That is stage one or phase one. The second phase, the second stage is when the parents leave for city life, leaving behind the child and mother, grandmother, and they move to the city. So the second stage be the turning point when grandmother and son move to the city, to the same house where parents had been living. That is the stage two, right? The third and the final phase before the grandson goes abroad is when the grandson goes to university, and while going to the university for higher studies, he shifts to the room in the hostel in the university campus, leaving behind his grandmother alone in that room. So these are the three phases in the story. And the fourth phase is, of course, when he goes abroad and comes back. So here are the three stages, three phases. The second question, give three reasons why the author's grandmother was disturbed. Author, as I said, author is the grandson. Author's mother, grandmother is disturbed when he started going to city school. Have you understood the question? Give three reasons why author's grandmother was disturbed when he started going to city school. Ve teen karan bataye jiske karan grandmother disturbed rehne lagi, dadi maa disturbed rehne lagi. Kab? जब ऑथर है, ऑथर शहर के स्कूल में जाने लगा. डू यू रिमेंबर दो थ्री पॉइंट्स? व्हाट वर द रीजंस फॉर हर गेटिंग डिस्टर्ब? नंबर वन, फर्स्ट रीजन वॉज दैट द चाइल्ड वुड नॉट बी ड्रॉप्ड बाय मदर टू द स्कूल. नाउ द चाइल्ड वॉज गोइंग बाय बस. तो मदर was not needed to go to school and that disturbed her. Grandmother was in the habit of dropping the child to school. And now the grandmother had just to come out of the house with the child, put him in the bus and come back. That disturbed her. The second reason why she was disturbed, grandmother would ask the child, "What have you learned today?" The child would speak about different topics that he learned. And as he says, Archimedes principle and world around us and some physics theory and so on and so forth. Mother will not be happy. Grandmother was disturbed when she learned that her grandchild is not learning anything so far as religious scriptures or prayers are concerned. Dharmic adhyayan kuch nahi tha. Ye janne ke baad mother bahut disturbed ho gayi thi. So the second point is grandmother was disturbed. Second reason is grandmother was disturbed because she learned that her grandson is not learning, or the school is not teaching my grandson anything about religion, neither religious scriptures or God or anything. The third reason why my mother was disturbed, the third reason was that when she learned that her son is learning music, she was disturbed. Because grandmother used to think, being an old-fashioned woman, she used to think that music is a subject of harlot, of beggars. I think you remember. Aapko yaad hoga ki grandmother ki soch thi ki jo sangeet hai, sangeet jaisi cheeze vaishyaon aur bhikhariyon se sambandhit rakhti hain. सभ्य समाज में संगीत का कोई स्थान नहीं है, और यहाँ मेरे ग्रैंडसन को स्कूल में संगीत सिखाया जा रहा है. ये भी दिस ऑल्सो डिस्टर्ब हर ग्रैंडमदर. सो वी हैव थ्री रीजंस व्हाई ग्रैंडमदर वर डिस्टर्ब व्हेन द चाइल्ड स्टार्टेड गोइंग टू स्कूल. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, मेंशन थ्री वेज इन विच the author's grandmother spent her days after he grew up. Three ways in which the author's grandmother spent her days with when he grew up. Jab ladka bada ho gaya, to bade hone ke baad kis tarike se, kin teen tarikon se author ki grandmother, mention three ways in which the author's grandmother spent her days after he grew up. Kin teen, aise teen tarike batayen, jiske anusar mother ne apna jeevan yapan kiya, kab? Jab ladka bada ho gaya. Ladka bada hone ka arth kya hai? When the son started going to university and started living there. And when he moved to the room there in the university, mother had to live alone. You remember? Pahla. So three ways in which the grandmother spent her days was, kis tarike se usne apne din guzare jab ladka bada ho gaya. To uska uttar hai, first way in which the grandmother has spent her days was in seclusion, akelapan, ekantvas. If you remember, in seclusion, because now there was no one, her grandson was no more there in the same room where she was living. Previously, they used to share the room. Now that sharing was gone. Now she was alone in the room. So what did she do? So first way was seclusion. What did she do? She kept praying. The second way in which she spent her days was when he grew up, she started offering breadcrumbs to the birds, Goraiya. She started offering them this thing in the afternoon. Dopahar mein, wah balcony mein, veranda mein, chidiyon ko bread ke tukde dekar apna samay kaatti thi aur uska anand leti thi. She would smile. So the second way in which she spent her days after the grandson grew up was by offering breadcrumbs to these birds around, who came in large number to veranda, to her veranda, to her balcony. The third way in which she would spend her time was by sitting on spinning wheel. चरखे पर बैठ कर वह अपना पूरा समय गुजारती थी. चरखे पर बैठ कर वह अपना पूरा समय गुजारती थी. Right from morning, after her morning routine is over, she would sit down on the spinning wheel and go on spinning, और सूत काटती रहती थी. रात तक यही काम चलता था और ऐसा करते हुए वह मुँह से बुदबुदाती रहती थी prayers. She would go on performing prayers. So this was the third way in which she would start spending her days after the grandson grew up. Right? Let's come to the fourth question. The fourth question is, mention the odd way in which the author's grandmother behaved just before she died. Mention the odd way in which the grandmother behaved just before her death. What was that odd way? Odd kya hota hai? Ek to odd ka ulta hota hai even. Yadi hum ganit ke numbers ki, ankon ki baat kare, to odd number aur even number hote hain. Even number matlab 2 4 6 8, 2 se jinka डिवीजन हो जाता, ऑड नंबर 1, 3, 5, 7 एट्सेट्रा. पर यहाँ ऑड का मतलब होता है विचित्र, अजीब तरीका. योर बिहेवियर इज़ वेरी ऑड, यू आर सिटिंग इन ए वेरी ऑड पोजीशन. तुम बड़े ऑड पोजीशन में बैठे हुए हो. बैठने की जो तुम्हारी जो शैली है वो बड़ी ऑड है, अजीब सी है. सो ऑड वे, ऐसी क्या अजीब बात हो गई थी ग्रैंड मदर की, जो ग्रैंड मदर ने जो आखिरी दिन अपनी मृत्यु के पहली रात, आखिरी दिन उन्होंने जो व्यवहार किया वो क्या ऑड था? कैन यू रिकॉल? द ऑड वे इन विच द ग्रैंड मदर बिहेव वॉज, इंस्टेड ऑफ डूइंग प्रेयर्स दैट शी हैड बीन डूइंग फॉर ईयर्स टुगेदर, शी हैड कॉल्ड अप women from the neighborhood and brought a drum, a very old drum, beating those drums and singing songs of warriors coming back home. I repeat again, the odd way in which the author's grandmother behaved was, she just called up just before she died, the previous night. She called up the neighborhood, women folk, and instead of prayers, she was singing song loudly, beating the drums, which were very old, and doing it for hours together till she was stopped by family member. परिवार के लोगों को कहना पड़ा कि आप रुक जाओ, अपने को ज़्यादा स्ट्रेन मत करो, अपने को ज़्यादा मत थकाओ. So that was the odd behavior. Odd because this was something she had never done. Fifth question. What was the way in which the sparrows expressed their sorrow when the author's grandmother died? Remember that The grandmother, dead body, was lying in a room, and people were around, and then the sparrows come in large number, as the author says, in thousands. So now the question is, in what way did the sparrows express their sorrow? Kis tarike se in chidiyon ne apna dukh prakat kiya? Tarika kya tha? Pehla, ve chup chap wahan baithi rahi. Koi chirping nahi, koi shorgul nahi. आई और चुपचाप बैठ गई. दूसरा तरीका जिसमें उन्होंने अपनी भावनाओं को व्यक्त किया, जो ऑथर की माँ थी, वो जब ब्रेड के टुकड़े लाके उन्होंने वहाँ फेंका चिड़ियों को देने के लिए, तो चिड़ियों ने नहीं लिया, उसकी ओर अनदेखी कर दी. और तीसरा, चिड़िया आई, ब्रेड के टुकड़ों को अनदेखी करते हुए शांत बैठी रही, और जैसे ही मृत शरीर को स्ट्रेचर में ले जाया गया, चुपचाप सब चिड़िया उड़ गई. सो द वे इन विच द स्पैरोज एक्सप्रेस देयर सॉरो वॉज, दे ऑल केम इन बिग नंबर, occupied the veranda, all sat down quietly with no noise, no chirping, and then did not even bother to look at the breads offered to them, and quietly flew off from the scene, from the veranda, once the body was taken off. Is it clear? I repeat again, all these birds, sparrows, they came quietly, scattered around, sat down on the floor in the veranda as they used to sit every day, but quiet. Did not even bother to notice, even look at the bread that were thrown by the author's mother, and flew off immediately the moment dead body of the grandmother was lifted up for funeral, was taken off from there. These birds also flew off to unknown destinations. That's how they expressed. No chirping, shant, all quiet, no eating also, as a mark of respect to the lady who had been giving them crumbs of bread day in and day out without a break for long hours. Now let's come to the next point, next pool of exercise. That's about the text, about the content. The point is, the author's grandmother was a religious person. Yes, we all know, all through we have read that the grandmother was very religious. Now the question is, what are the different ways in which we come to know that she was a religious person and so religious? In other words, you have to mention the ways in which we can she expressed her religious bent of mind. Kin tarikon se hame pata lagta hai ki jo dadi maa thi wo bahut dharmik mahila thi. Dharmik mahila thi ye to hum samajh gaye. पर वे तरीके बताएं जिनसे हमें महसूस होता है कि वे एक धार्मिक महिला थी. फर्स्टली आंसर इज, फर्स्टली शी वुड ऑलवेज हैव रोजरी बीड ऑन हर हैंड. एक हाथ में हमेशा उनके जपने की माला रहती थी. एंड अलोंग विद दैट शी वुड ऑलवेज कीप saying prayers visible from the movement of her lips. और उसके साथ ही वो हमेशा कुछ ना कुछ प्रेयर बोलती रहती थी जो उनके होठों से दिखता था. होठों की जो बुदबुदाहट थी उससे लगता था साफ कि वो कुछ प्रेयर ही बोल रही हैं. सो फर्स्ट वे शी वुड ऑलवेज हैव रोजरी बीड ऑन हर हैंड. शी विल कीप रोलिंग इट एज इफ काउंटिंग एंड विल कीप सेइंग प्रेयर्स visible through the movement of her lips. Yes, other way. The other way is that she would take her grandson to the temple. In the name of a school, she would take her child to the temple next to the school, make the grandson sit for prayers and for alphabet singing. And she would herself go into a room for reading scriptures. धार्मिक पुस्तकों को पढ़ने के लिए गांव के स्कूल के पास जो मंदिर था वहां वो बच्चे के साथ हमेशा जाती थी. और बच्चा जब अल्फाबेट याद करता था, प्रेयर याद करता था वरेंडा में बैठकर, तो ग्रैंड मदर जो हैं वो अंदर के कमरे में जाकर धार्मिक पुस्तक पढ़ती थी. दैट वॉज द अदर वे टू प्रूव दैट मदर वॉज ए ग्रैंड मदर वॉज वेरी रिलीजियस. सो द सेकेंड वे इज इन विच वी कैन प्रूव. वॉट इज द सेकेंड वे फॉर? सेकेंड वे फॉर प्रूविंग दैट शी वॉज वेरी रिलीजियस इज दैट ग्रैंड मदर वुड ऑलवेज स्पेंड टाइम इन रीडिंग स्क्रिप्चर्स एट द टेम्पल, इनर रूम ऑफ द टेम्पल, when the grandson would be busy learning alphabets and prayers in the veranda of the temple. The third way in which we can say that she was a very religious woman was that she would always keep saying one prayer or the other. Lip movement will be constant there, and all along, all through the lip movement, she would just keep uttering some prayer or the other, which was not audible to the grandson or understandable by the grandson, because he did not even try to understand. But all he knew was that she is doing some prayer, she is performing some prayers. So these are the three ways in which we can say that the grandmother was a very religious woman. The next, it's a little long question. Describe the relationship, the changing relationship between the author and the grandmother. I repeat, describe the changing relationship between the grandmother and the author. While describing, you have to mention that whether their relationship, their feelings ever change. Also mention, did their feelings ever change for each other? हिंदी में प्रश्न स्पष्ट है कि grandmother और grandchild के बीच के बदलते हुए संबंधों का वर्णन करें, बदलते हुए संबंधों का वर्णन करें. उसी में दूसरा प्रश्न है, क्या उनके बीच में जो संबंध था उसमें कोई बदलाव आया? एक दूसरे के प्रति जो सोच थी, फीलिंग्स थी, एक दूसरे के प्रति जो भावनाएं थी, उसमें कुछ बदलाव आया क्या? व्हाट इज द आंसर? व्हेन वी डिस्क्राइब द चेंजिंग रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द ऑथर एंड द ग्रैंडसन मदर, वी नीड टू स्टार्ट. Firstly, their relations were very friendly. The grandson himself has said that we were very friendly. We would live in one room. He would tell us fables of prophets. And she would make him ready, make him dressed, prepare breakfast for him, and also go along with him to school, to the temple. That shows the close bond. Thereafter, when the parents left the grandson along with grandmother, along with the son's grandson's grandmother. they did not carry the grandson with him. Just because they had very close bonding. Their relations were very close. So grandmother and son and grandson remained in village house for some more time till this family settled down with city life. That also shows that they had good relations. Thereafter, as the times rolled by, they both came to the city. Both of them preferred to live in one room. Grandmother and the grandson, they lived in one room in the city also. The fact that grandmother was making the child take bath, dress up, dressing him up, preparing breakfast for him, bringing slate, pencil, reading everything. In other words, taking care of everything of the child, it shows the close bond between the two. The same bond continued when they came to city. They lived together, mother would be preparing something, but one thing changed in the city, and that was grandmother was no more taking the child to the school, because the child was going by school bus now. Being the city, the school was far away, and so obviously the child had to go to school by bus, and so grandmother felt it. But she knew that she can't, that there's no way, it's not possible for both of them to go walking. So she accepted it. She accepted it quietly. Further, mother was not able to teach the grandson now, because grandson had different subjects. He would talk of different subjects. Now, grandmother did not find son learning anything religion, learning anything about scripture. But the grandmother did not protest, because there was no reason for protesting. That is how the school education is. So mother accepted this fact that, well, the son had to go without it. Now the time has come when the son has to learn more of these things. Further, their bonding is very clearly visible with changing times. When the son went to the university hostel, mother accepted it, but then that she loved her child, that was very clear from the fact that when the grandson decided to go abroad, grandmother came to drop him to the railway station and sort of kissed his forehead, moistened his forehead with her kiss. And the grandson also cherished that moment, cherished that feeling of the physical contact that the two had. You remember that line? That the grandson really felt very happy when grandmother kissed him, and the moistened face where the kiss mark was there, that feeling was there for him that he cherished for long. And he wondered, ki kya aage fir kabhi main hum logon ke beech mein sambandh ho payega, kya hum ek dusre se mil payenge? Because the grandson was going for how many years? He was going out for 5 years. That shows that right from childhood their bonding was continued. And the last and the most important incident as per this story, that shows that there was close feeling, there was no love lost between the two, was mother lived up to see that child comes back, and only after that he breathed his last. ग्रैंडमदर ने सुनिश्चित किया था कि वो तब तक जिंदा रहेंगी जब तक कि उनका ग्रैंडसन विदेश से वापस नहीं आएगा और इनसे मिलेगा नहीं. ग्रैंडसन आया, ग्रैंडमदर ने उसे देखा, ग्रैंडमदर ने उसे हग किया, रैप्ड अराउंड आर्म, और उसके बाद दोनों वापस घर आए और मदर ने, ग्रैंड मदर ने फिर महिलाओं को बुलाकर पहली बार प्रेयर ना करते हुए महिलाओं के साथ संगीत गाया। अपने बेटे के सम्मान में मानो कोई योद्धा वापस आया हो। शी चैंटेड सॉन्ग, शी संग सॉन्ग्स इन ऑनर ऑफ हर ग्रैंड सन हु हैड कम बैक आफ्टर 5 years। नो प्रेयर शी डिड दैट डे एंड शी सैंग इट फॉर लॉन्ग टिल शी वॉज स्टॉप्ड। एंड वॉट वॉज द लाइन सॉन्ग्स ऑफ दोज पोएम, अ वॉरियर कमिंग बैक आफ्टर विक्ट्री ऑल्सो, दैट वॉज द फीलिंग इन दोज लाइन्स। एंड देयर आफ्टर शी डाइड, देयर आफ्टर शी ब्रीथ हिज लास्ट। दिस शोज दैट देयर वर नो चेंज इन द फीलिंग आइदर ऑफ द चाइल्ड टूवर्ड द ग्रैंड मदर और ऑफ द ग्रैंड मदर टूवर्ड हर चाइल्ड। इससे बड़ा स्पष्ट है कि शुरू से अंत तक ना तो दादी माँ के प्रति ग्रैंड सन के फीलिंग में कोई अंतर था और ना ही ग्रैंड सन के नज़रिए से ग्रैंड माँ के फीलिंग में कोई अंतर था। ग्रैंड माँ, ग्रैंड मदर एक्सेप्ट कर रही थी जो चेंजेस हो रहे थे, लेकिन कभी प्रोटेस्ट नहीं किया, कभी नाराज़गी उन्होंने प्रदर्शित नहीं की। वेल, तो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द आंसर टू दिस। नाउ द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज, वुड यू एग्री दैट द ऑथर ग्रैंड मदर वॉज ए स्ट्रांग पर्सन इन कैरेक्टर। कैरेक्टर में ग्रैंड मदर बहुत स्ट्रांग थी, क्या आप सहमत हैं इस बात से? स्ट्रांग कैरेक्टर मतलब दृढ़ निश्चय वाली, दृढ़ इच्छाओं वाली। इफ यस, गिव इंस्टेंसेस दैट शो दिस। यदि सहमत हैं तो उदाहरण बताएं इस कहानी से। इंस्टेंस माने उदाहरण। आई रिपीट द क्वेश्चन, वुड यू एग्री दैट द ग्रैंड मदर हैड ए वेरी स्ट्रांग कैरेक्टर? इफ यस, गिव इंस्टेंसेस to support your view। ऐसे कौन से उदाहरण हैं इस कहानी में जिससे स्पष्ट हो कि माँ जो थी बड़े दृढ़ निश्चय वाली थी? सबसे बड़ा उदाहरण तो ये कि इतनी दृढ़ निश्चय थी उनमें कि अपने ग्रैंड सन को मरने के पहले एक बार देखना चाहती थी और तब तक उन्होंने सुनिश्चित किया मानो कि मैं जिंदा रहूं। शी वॉज सच ए स्ट्रांग वुमन that she lived to see her grandson the last time before she dies। doesn't it prove, kya aise siddh nahi hota ki bahut strong character ke the? dusra character ke udaharan yadi le, charitra ka, she constantly right from the childhood times of the child till he grew up always a religious woman। She always had beads on her hand, rosary bead. She would always keep murmuring the prayers. She would make sure that the child is taken to the temple, make sure that she reads scriptures, etc. That shows the strong will ki har sthiti mein main dharmik rahungi. Next example, third and the last, that when she was in village, she would offer bread to the dogs. स्ट्रीट डॉग्स, स्ट्रे डॉग्स, जब गांव में थी तो कुत्तों को खिलाती थी। शी वॉज सच ए स्ट्रांग विल्ड वूमन दैट वेन शी केम टू सिटी शी डिसाइडेड टू ऑफर ब्रेड क्रम्स टू द स्पैरोज बिकॉज द डॉग्स आर नॉट देयर। सो दीज इंस्टेंसेस शो दैट शी वॉज अ वेरी स्ट्रांग विल्ड वूमन। एंड दीज आर थ्री एग्जाम्पल्स, एटलीस्ट देर आर फ्यू मोर, but three examples are enough to prove this point. Last point about this text is, have you known someone like the author's grandmother? kya aap author ke grandmother jaise kisi mahila ko jante ho? do you feel the same sense of loss with regard to someone whom you had hate, you have loved and lost? क्या कभी तुम्हारे मन में वही विचार आते हैं जैसे कि यहाँ ग्रैंड सन के मन में आए जिसको आपने खोया हो? पर्टिकुलरली इन दीज कोरोना डेज, इन द लास्ट 2 years, वी हैव लॉस्ट मैनी नियर डियर वंस। very close ones, and lost them very suddenly. They were all healthy, they were fine, keeping fit. And suddenly they die because of corona, because falling ill due to corona. So the question is, do you feel the sense of loss with regard to someone you have lost? I think I'm sure the answer is yes, I do feel the sense of loss at the loss of so and so, who was very close to me, either as a friend or as a friend's parent or as some relative or something. So the sense of loss is felt by every individual who is a human being.